Number two, Bobby Dagen from Saw 3D. One of the things people always wanted to do in a Saw film was talk about Jigsaw survivors. Like, what are the survivor groups up to? What are they? Who are they? What have they been up to? And everything like that. And we finally get that in the last, supposedly last Saw movie. And yet the character we're stuck with in the last Saw movie is this guy, Bobby Dagen. Played by Sean Patrick Flannery, this guy writes a book about supposedly surviving a Jigsaw trap. And yet, while being an idiot, he wrote that book while Jigsaw was still alive, testing people. Yeah, you didn't think that one through, did you, Bobby? So, of course, he gets tested, and then he has to go through the test and survive the game in order to save his wife. And to be honest, folks, as much as I love Sean Patrick Flannery, and he's great in the Boondock Saints, this character was ultimately kind of pointless. And the reason why I say that is simple. Like, yes, we know, just from the moment we meet him, we know, you, sir, are a liar. And the whole point of the trap is Jigsaw telling him, you, sir, are a liar, and you are going to get tested, and you're going to find out what it truly means to survive. Okay, so the whole twist in the movie is to build up, is he lying, is he not lying, is he telling the truth? It's like, we know this guy is lying. We know, we have to endure. And yet, well, the only person we have sympathetic towards at this whole thing is his wife. And then what do? They kill her. Like, she had no reason to die. All because this guy lied? It's like, it was just kind of a mess in general. So, I know you're about ready to grill Bobby Dagen in the moment, but to me, this character was just kind of pointless. And to think, this was the final character they chose to be the final game focus. Your supposed last Saw movie, and this is the character you write and give us to be the last guy in the traps? Talk about a letdown.
Bobby's character is one of the worst in the entire franchise, and I think it's more about what they wanted to do with this movie and what they wrote than what we ultimately end up seeing. Because I remember in the original shooting script, his wife was in on it, just like everybody else helping him. So it makes a little bit more sense why you kill her. But we don't see that, and it really ruins that whole climactic moment of him failing to help her by recreating the trap that he said he already went through, right? That to me never sits right. You're right. The fact that his wife dies is really cruel. And everything about Bobby and his connection with John kind of ruins John's character a little bit. Like, John is super petty in this movie. The only real time that we see him in Saw 3D is when he gets up in his face and is like, you didn't survive a trap and I know it, blah, blah, blah. It's like, would John care? And the only reason that he cares is because it's implied in the shooting script that he was helping Gordon understand his method, and he wanted Gordon to start the whole group, bring people in, and brainwash them to all carry out the legacy. Literally, that is what the script was. And the one thing we got, because they cut out all of that nonsense, because it really wouldn't have worked and it would have made the movie even worse in my opinion, but what we're left with is kind of a shell of a character who is limited in the effectiveness of what he's trying to do, because Saul is, you know, for all of its fame and fortune and everything, is still kind of a low budgeted movie. I mean, $10 million is not a small amount of money, but for a movie it is. And I kind of always imagine, like, it would have been more effective if it wasn't directly tied to John. No flashbacks, no book sales. John never went to go see him and throw him in his face or something. The survivor group was something completely genuine that he was trying to profit on. And Hoffman set up the game in order to distract everyone, but needed someone to throw in a game. And he knew that Bobby had never done anything. But at the same time, Bobby is not just somebody meeting in a church. Like, he has a national stage. And it also props up the idea that people now know who John Kramer is. Like, this guy is, he's taken out FBI agents, most wanted list, all this other stuff. People know who this guy is, what he's done, and are fascinated by him. And this guy's coming up with fame, telling everyone that he is this, he's a survivor, he's going to help them, he's going to teach them what John Kramer wants everyone to know. without them having to go through the test because he's already done it for them. He's a savior. That to me makes a lot more sense if it's bigger than what we saw in the movie. There's so much about his character that's interesting, as you said, but it fails on every single conceivable level that it just ends up becoming obnoxious, and it doesn't only ruin his character, it kind of ruins John a little bit too. And the fact that Hoffman had no idea, or at least no involvement with planning any of this trap other than just setting it into motion, kind of makes Hoffman, you know, Bobby's kind of a dick. Hoffman is kind of a dick, but I mean, it's kind of deserving. It just kind of muddies the waters a lot in the final film that you really don't want to see.
Plus, he's an idiot. Hook the hooks into your jeans, you fool.